A European infrastructure project takes shape, planned, engineered and implemented in sections. The upgraded and new railway line between Nuremberg and Berlin. Germany's largest and most innovative infrastructure development, the German Unification Traffic Project No. 8, the key section of the eastern main line that runs north-south between Scandinavia and northern Italy. A line built for speeds up to 300 kilometers an hour, following the latest European standard. Financed by the Federal Republic of Germany, the European Union and Deutsche Bahn. Construction work is currently focusing on more than 200 kilometers of new built line in Bavaria, Thuringia and Saxony-Anhalt to accommodate the current and future demand for European passenger and freight traffic in an eco-friendly manner. When I think of the German Unification Traffic Project No. 8, I think of very long development and planning phases. And now finally, I look ahead to the completion of the tracks in 2015 and 17. We will see a significant reduction in journey times between Berlin and Munich. The goal is to offer a service that can compete with air travel in particular by cutting journey times to well below 4 hours. The line will also have much less of an impact on the environment, and we want to continue to offer more capacity for freight traffic to shift more freight from the roads to the rails. New tracks will speed up both passenger and freight traffic. Avoiding congested roads, rail travel is faster and better for the environment. The planning phase begins in 1992. Projects are created section by section, weighing up different options, taking economic, technological and environmental aspects into consideration. Planning permission is granted by the Federal German Railway Authority following a public consultation. The latest technology and techniques are being used for this 10 billion euro project, including state-of-the-art electronic signal box technology. Construction work on the southern section 8.1 from Nuremberg to Erfurt, starting with an 83-kilometer long line upgrade, an extension to four tracks towards Forchheim, Bamberg and as far as Ebensfeld, with new rail tracks, bridges and stations, also for suburban S-Bahn trains as part of a new S-Bahn network for the metropolitan region. The starting point is Nuremberg main station. On the line from Nuremberg to Fürth, the first 7.5 kilometers are now in operation with four tracks. It is between these two cities that the first German locomotive made its first journey back in December 1835. Today it's part of a busy railway junction. An additional track for the suburban S-Bahn trains and a tunnel for freight traffic will help to relieve congestion at this intersection. The construction work is carried out day and night during normal operations and during intensive construction phases when some railway lines are closed, railway bridges across the Frankenschnellweg motorway. In future, the S-Bahn trains will reach up to 140 kilometers an hour and the ICEs up to 230. Northwards through the Fürther Bogen, with the extended Siebenbogen bridge and a separate track for the S-Bahn trains. South of Erlangen, the existing line, the S-Bahn and the freight traffic lines merge into a four-track line towards Ebensfeld. The Erlangen section is under construction. An extension from two to four tracks and new intersections between local transport and the railway. There are information centers in Fürth and Erlangen. North of Bamberg at Zapfendorf, the upgraded and newly constructed lines are linked. Near Ebensfeld, a line branches off to the new 107-kilometer-long track towards Erfurt. 22 tunnels and 29 viaducts take the track under and across the Thuringian forest, starting with a railway embankment interspersed with large bridges across new floodways for the River Main, all in an environmentally sound design. The first tunnel, the Eierberger Tunnel, is the longest in the project in Bavaria at 3.8 kilometers. The view from the local information center over the Main Valley at Bad Staffelstein. Under construction, the Kolch and Lichtenholz tunnels. After the Weißenbrunn Viaduct comes the Nuremberg Tunnel, early August 2012, the last breakthrough of a total of 56 tunnel kilometres for the new line. Before the Füllbach Bridge, Coburg will be linked to the new main line to reach the town of Rödental to the northeast via the Rennberg and Feuerfelsen tunnels, where another information centre is located. Already completed the Itztal Bridge to the east of Coburg. Near Rödental in Upper Franconia, the Froschgrundsee Viaduct, with an arch that spans 270 metres, a European record. It has been designed in this way to protect the floor of the valley. Through the new Moos Tunnel to the Grümpental Bridge in Thuringia, up to 70 metres high. Later the trains will cover the distance of 1,100 metres in a few brief moments. The arch is completed at the end of 2009. The auxiliary supports are removed in November 2010. The 270 metre arch now stands unaided. After the Baumleiter Tunnel near Treuern, a 27 metre deep cut just over a kilometre long for the four-track overtaking station. Right afterwards, construction of the Trockental Bridge 55 metres above the ground to bring trains to the Blesberg Tunnel. The tunnel runs for 300 metres under the ridge of the Thuringian forest with a length of over 8 kilometres. It's the third longest tunnel in Germany and the longest of this project. Work on the tunnel continues with blasting and securing around the clock. As with all the tunnels along this route, this one will receive a second inner tube. Breakthrough on the 29th of June 2011. In May 2008, the team was surprised to find an impressive cast cave. It's secured and the tunneling work continues unimpeded. In total, over 1.6 billion cubic meters of stone have been excavated and removed from the mountain via an intermediate gallery. The material will be reused to shape a typical Thuringian landscape. Near Goldistal, the line reaches the Saubach Bridge, which is currently used as a construction road together with the Goldberg Tunnel. The highest point of the line, 603 metres above sea level. From viewing platforms, visitors can get a good look at the construction work, bridges and tunnels in rapid succession. Visitors can access the site on short walking trails from the Railway Information Centre at Goldistal and from Masserberg. Other highlights along the route, the Masserberg Tunnel, the Massetal Bridge, the Fleckberg Tunnel, the final breakthrough in Thuringia in March 2012. Then the Ölzetal Bridge, and here as well, once the auxiliary supports have been blasted away, the arch stands unaided in the Kerb Valley. And from the 7.4 kilometre long Silberberg Tunnel, driven via two intermediate galleries, the shaping areas for the excavated material on the Ilmsenberg near Großbreitenbach. Valleys and tunnels in rapid succession, and finally after the Tragberg Tunnel, the opening into the Ilm Valley at Langewiesen. The viaduct at nearly 1,700 metres, it will be the longest in Thuringia, closing the gap in March 2011. From here, it's another 37 kilometres to Erfurt, with three tunnels and eight bridges along the way. The route runs parallel to the A71 motorway for much of the way. Here, the line is already being equipped with overhead lines and slab track. Then, the link to the existing route network. Next stop, Erfurt Main Station, a new structure. It opened in December 2008 and includes shops, businesses and a multi-storey car park on the lower levels. Above is a busy rail junction of various ICE routes, which are being linked to each other and to the regional network on a 7-kilometre-long construction site here at the Erfurt Hub. Trains continue to run while work is going on. North of Erfurt, section 8.2, the 123-kilometre-long new line to Leipzig-Halle, a construction site with a length of 100 kilometres, until it's linked to the existing rail network in Gröbers, with heavy earthworks in the Thuringian basin, with dozens of intersecting bridges with six viaducts, overall length 14.4 kilometres. One of these is the Scherkonde Valley Bridge, a very special bridge, one of five bridges in the project designed as an integral structure without any bearings or joints. It's an ultra-slim design in line with the latest bridge-building technology. In 2012, it was awarded the German Bridge Construction Prize. And possibly the most innovative bridge of the project, the integral Gänsebach Valley Bridge at Buchstedt. Also part of section 8.2, three tunnels with a total length of over 15 kilometres past the Thuringian basin, the Finne tunnel on the border between Thuringia and Saxony-Anhalt, excavated by two tunnel drilling machines. The first drilling machine reaches its destination in September 2009, after 17 months of excavation. The shield with a diameter of 11 meters. The machine in the southern tube reaches its destination in early 2010, after the one in the northern tube. The watertight tunnel tubes, up to 40 meters below the water table, consist of concrete segments which are pre-cast on site. Further along the line, two single-track bridges across the Saubach Valley serve as temporary access to the construction site for the 6.5-kilometre-long Bibra Tunnel, a double breakthrough celebration for the Finne and Bibra Tunnels in March 2010. Construction work between Erfurt and Leipzig-Halle reaches the halfway stage. An innovative project crossing the Unstrut Valley near Karsdorf. The bridge, a structure without bearings, over 2.5 kilometres long. In July 2012, the completion of the last bridge segment is celebrated, and the construction site has an open house, a celebration for many guests in Saxony-Anhalt. Right next to the bridge, the Osterberg Tunnel. After 2 kilometres through the Shell limestone, the tunnel breakthrough in November 2009. The structural work on the tunnels between Erfurt and Leipzig is completed in 2012. The next step is equipping the line with track, rails and overhead lines. 83 kilometres of new traction power supply lines ensure electrical mobility. At the eastern portal of the Osterberg Tunnel, the Railway Information Centre in Kalzendorf opened in 2012. The previous centre, some kilometres to the south, attracted more than 50,000 visitors. With the new section of the project, the exhibition is moved here, where it continues to attract great interest. Secured before the start of construction work, archaeological treasures on hundreds of acres, 5,000 years of central German transport and trade history. Settlements between Unstrut and Saale, larger than the ancient city of Troy. On the Querfurt plate, shown here with a 20-kilometre-long excavation. In the southern part of Halle, the line divides into the 6.5-kilometre-long Saale-Elster viaduct towards Leipzig and the 2-kilometre branch line towards Halle. Built with low environmental impact on an elevated track, to protect the delicate ecology of the water meadows. A launching girder with a length of 132 metres eliminates construction roads. As along the entire line, new habitats to balance out the inevitable intrusion into nature during construction on more than 1,000 acres in the area south of Halle alone. From the Saale-Elster Valley, the main line continues via the new railway intersection of Gröbers to the new 23-kilometre-long section with Halle-Leipzig Airport Station, which opened in 2003, linking road, rail and air traffic. A final point in section 8.2, the impressive Leipzig main station, ready by 2015 for the new built line with new tracks, bridges and platforms. From the south of Halle, the bridge branch line into the city on the river Saale. Halle main station extensively refurbished in recent years. Integration while trains continue to run. From Leipzig and Halle to Berlin, section 8.3 is realized as a line upgrade. 1 hour service from Leipzig to Berlin was first offered in 2006 at a speed of 200 kilometers an hour. With the refurbishment of the stations and new bridges across the river Mulde and the river Elbe at Wittenberg. With bridges and underpasses instead of time-consuming level crossings, no more barriers, and since May 2006, a new station for the capital.
I think we're very well positioned, in particular as we've firmed up the completion dates with the German government for the major sections, the two new lines in 2015 and 17. We're well on the way, so our German section of the main European line will be completed relatively early. A European transport project takes shape. The goal is a journey time of around 4 hours between Munich and Berlin. Max Malwurf, the Deutsche Bahn construction mole, will accompany the construction works all the way.